Many people think that in order to drive more traffic to your store and make more sales, you must invest on ads. However, this is not true. Hi there, I am Rehab, and on this YouTube channel, I share with you videos related to e-commerce, entrepreneurship, and more. And in today's video, I'm going to show you my top and favorite methods to bring free traffic to your store and increase your sales without paying any dollar. So let's start. The first method I want to talk about is SEO or search engine optimization. If you don't know what is SEO, let me explain a little bit. SEO is when you optimize your store so it ranks for certain keywords on Google. So you optimize your product pages, your collection pages, and your homepage in order to rank for long-tail keywords on Google. And when you do that, you keep getting free traffic for years to come. However, you should know something. SEO is a long-term procedure, which means that if you started optimizing your store for SEO today, you would need months before starting to see results. That's why if you are patient and you have time, I highly recommend you to invest on SEO. However, if you want quick results and fast results, you must consider the following methods because most of them are very quick methods and they can bring you direct sales. Before moving to the second method, I want to mention that on this YouTube channel, there is a free tutorial that shows you step by step how you can optimize your store for SEO. So don't forget to check it after watching this video. And if you want to take your SEO optimization to a totally next level, I highly recommend you to check my SEO Shopify Masterclass. You will find the link below in the description for this course. Now moving to the second method, which is something I truly love and it's something I'm very passionate about, and it is content marketing. Content marketing and SEO go hand by hand because it's way easier to rank on Google for a blog post than to rank with a product page. And let me explain this a little bit more. If you go to Google and search for sleeping products, you can notice that almost all of the results on the first page on the search are blog articles. And that's why content marketing is important, because it's way easier to rank with a blog post than to rank with a product page. People go to Google to ask questions. So let's say, for example, you have a store where you are selling sleeping products and you have a blog section with multiple blog posts where you are discussing topics related to how to sleep well or what you should be eating before sleeping and things like that. When people go to Google and find you through these articles, they would appreciate the help you are offering and they will be more attached to your brand and to what you are offering. And through these articles, you can be advertising to your products, or you can simply be collecting your customers' leads in order to advertise for them in the future using email marketing. However, similar to SEO, content marketing needs time and dedication, and you would need months before starting to see results. So if you are aiming for quick results, content marketing would not be your first and favorite method. However, if you want my opinion, I highly recommend you to do content marketing, because using content marketing, you don't only bring free traffic to your store, but you also create a much stronger connection with your audience, because people appreciate when you help them and when you provide solutions for their problems. Now, before moving to the next method, let me explain something. Many e-commerce stores rely entirely on Facebook ads to bring traffic, and this is extremely wrong. Not only because they always need to invest money in order to attract the traffic, but also it is wrong because it means that they are relying entirely on a third-party platform. What would happen if your Facebook ads account got banned? Or what would happen is if Facebook doesn't exist anymore? What would happen if the costs of Facebook ads become more and more expensive? How would you solve this problem? Well, if you are aiming to create a sustainable business, you can't be relying your entire marketing on one platform. You should be thinking about how to create a true business that's able to attract the traffic, convert this traffic, and retain the customers. And this is exactly what I show you inside of my e-commerce growth workshop. So if you are looking to move your business to a totally next level, if you are looking to create a business that can live for years, if you are looking to retain your customers, I highly recommend you to go down and to take this free workshop. In this workshop, you will learn how you can increase your sales, how you can bring more traffic, how you can retain your customers, and many, many other things that will make your e-commerce business boost and that will increase your sales and make your business sustainable and strong, and that will help your business to live for years and years. So don't forget to go down and to take this free workshop. Now moving to the third method, which is, in my opinion, might be the favorite one for many of you, and it is to create strong social media profiles. And here, let me explain a little bit more about that, and let me explain why I didn't say create strong Instagram profiles. Well, before deciding on which social media profile you want to focus your efforts, you have to think first of your audience, and you have to ask yourself where your audience is. So it depends on your niche, it depends on what products you are selling, and it depends on your audience age. So if you have, for example, a brand where you are selling cosmetic products for women above 40 years old, Instagram might not be your favorite place because older people are usually on Facebook. That's why when you know your potential customers in a very good way and when you are very well aware of the audience you are targeting, you can easily answer this question and you can easily decide which is your favorite platform. Because if you start this thinking that you are going to create a very big YouTube channel and a very strong Instagram profile and a very big Facebook page, you will end up doing nothing. You have to focus on one social media platform or maximum two, and you have to stick to them. And by sticking to them, I mean that you should be consistent. Let's say, for example, you decided to go with an Instagram profile and you decided that your audience is on Instagram. So you should be setting up a schedule for your posts and you should be thinking about how many times you are going to post per week. I recommend you to at least post 3 times. Even better if you can post 7 times, and I recommend you to post not only pictures related to your products and what you are selling, but I also recommend you to post content, which means post tips, post ideas, and post things that will help your audience, because in this way you will increase your exposure and you will be able to reach out to more and more people. In addition to create social media profiles for your brand, you can also create pages on your niche where you advertise your store indirectly. So for example, you can create a memes page or maybe a quotes page related to your niche, and you can advertise your products on this page without showing your brand directly. So these pages usually attract a lot of traffic and people like them. That's why it's easier to build them than to build a normal brand profile. Now let's move to the method number 4, which is the internet community groups. And by this I mean things like Facebook groups, maybe subreddits, maybe places like Quora and so on. Usually people who are interested about the same topic or who share the same interests go to places like that to ask questions and to exchange knowledge. That's why, let's say for example you have a store where you sell yoga accessories, you can go to Facebook groups for yoga lovers and try in there to advertise your store. However, you have to be very cautious in there, because if you went there directly and you started advertising to your store, you will get banned. So instead of doing that, you should be going in there, you should be helping people, providing value, and indirectly, you should be advertising for your store. So don't go in there and start posting your links up and above and beyond and everywhere. Don't do that, please. Go in there, provide value, help people, and indirectly introduce your store for people. The same thing goes for Reddit. So you go in there and you reply to people's questions and you help them out and you share your links if you have some valuable links to introduce. The same thing can be applied to Quora. So you go in there and you reply to people's questions and you try to help them out. And if you are doing content marketing, which means if you are publishing blog posts and so on, you can use your blog posts in order to drive traffic to your store indirectly. So let's say, for example, some people are asking about how to sleep at night. You can reply to that question and you can include your blog post link in order to let people know about your store and know about your products through your blog post. With this method, you can bring direct sales and you don't need to wait months in order to see results. However, it's a method that needs a lot of time and dedication from your part, because you should be contributing continuously to these platforms and you should always be providing value in order to not get banned and in order to stay on these platforms and in order to keep using these platforms as a way to attract free traffic to your store. Now moving to our final method, which is to work with small influencers and bloggers. And by small, I mean influencers who are still growing up and they are not that big yet. So maybe between 5K to 15K or something like that. And why do I recommend you to work with those influencers? Because those influencers might accept to advertise your products in return of a gift or something like that. Let's say, for example, you have a store that sells shoes. Many of those small influencers will accept to advertise to your products in return of a pair of shoes. As simple as that. So this is the final method I recommend, and it usually brings you quick sales, and it is very, very efficient. So these were my top 5 methods to bring free traffic to your store. If you are using one of them or maybe multiple ones of them, please let me know in the comment section below and let's discuss this a little bit further. Now before leaving, I want to invite you to go down to the description and to take the free workshop I'm currently offering. In this workshop, I walk you step by step through how you can create a sustainable, strong e-commerce business. Now with the iOS 14 update and with everything going on, people are starting more and more to get scared about relying entirely on Facebook ads to bring traffic. So now more than ever, it's very important to create a business that's strong and sustainable, and a business that can attract the traffic and that can retain customers and gain them for life. And this is exactly what I teach in this workshop. So if you are interested about creating a sustainable e-commerce business, and if you want to take your business to a totally next level, I highly recommend you to go down and to take this free workshop. It's 100% free. You just need to sign up. See you there, and bye bye.